Hello everyone and welcome to a new video. In case this is the first video of this series you're watching, I highly recommend watching previous part 1 and part 2 videos on how we built our own custom plant sensor, solenoid driver and central unit. Links are in the video description. In this video, we will integrate all of these individual parts that we have built so far to work together and show how we can collect the data, analyze it and automate things. Also, I have been using this system for over a year now and I'm absolutely thrilled with how well it works and how easy it is to use once you have everything set up. But every system has room for improvement and this one is no different, so I will be sharing some ideas on future improvements and things I would do differently if I were to do it all over again. There are many different ways to collect sensor data, store it, analyze it, and automate things. So what I'm showing in this video is something that works well for me and my use case. But we have intentionally built our watering system to be platform agnostic and easy to integrate with any other system. So if you like different tools or have an approach that you prefer, I strongly encourage you to experiment and do things your way because that's what I did and it works great for me. Here is a very high level diagram of what is going on in our system. We have a central unit that reads sensor data in real time. We can easily access it over the web interface and read the data in JSON format. Every time we reload the page, the latest and greatest sensor data is shown, but we don't have data from previous readings. That means we don't know what were the values, for example, 5 minutes ago or an hour ago or yesterday. So without knowing previous values, it's hard to make sense of the data and almost impossible to visualize or track trends. We can easily solve this by storing real-time data into a database so we can analyze it at a later time. For this, I'm using MySQL database server. You can use any other database system like MariaDB, InfluxData, SQLite, MangoDB, or any other database solution you like. Main reason I went with MySQL was that I already had servers that I use for other projects, so if you already have something running, go with what you're comfortable with. I won't go into details on how to set up a MySQL database and create tables and so on. There are too many great videos and guides explaining how to do this in detail, but if you decide that you want to copy my setup, I have included all the source files in the GitHub repository, including MySQL database structure. Okay, now that we have real-time data from central unit and database system, we need to link these two by taking readings from central unit in regular intervals, for example every 15 minutes, and store them into a database. For this video, I chose to use N8N because, again, I already used it for something else, and also N8N is fairly simple and straightforward that anyone should be able to set it up and use fairly easily. So in N8N, we are going to create a new workflow that uses cron as a task scheduler. This task will run every 15 minutes and pull the JSON data from the central unit via HTTP request. Then we are going to use a function to parse that data and then finally insert it into our MySQL database. This is essentially a very fancy way of saying N8N is going to store website data into a database every 15 minutes. Also, every time I pull the data, I also make a couple of checks to make sure plant system is online and correct number of sensors is present. Or otherwise, the system will send me a notification via Telegram to let me know what is wrong. We don't need to dig into step-by-step details on how to do this, since you get the idea how this works, and also if you're not using N8N, the steps and tools you use might be different. If you decide to use N8N, you can take a closer look at the workflow source code in the GitHub repo. With these steps completed, we are storing sensor data every 15 minutes, and we are doing it all day, every day. But this means that we are just storing the data in the database. We still need a way to visualize the data and present it in a user-friendly way. Probably the easiest way to consume time series data is through graphs, so we will graph our data over time. Now, here we could again use many different solutions like Grafana or Python's PyPlot or Visualize or many other. But I'm going to go with Grafana and you've guessed it because I'm already using it for other projects. In Grafana, I have created a dashboard to display temperature, soil moisture, and ambient light over time and plot it for each individual plant. Here you can see that we can easily visualize the data and inspect for each individual plant and also observe trends over arbitrary time periods. I don't know about you, but I find this very cool. But cool aside, this can be very useful, for example, to see how your plants are behaving. Are they getting enough sunlight or water? Are they too hot or too cold, and so on. I am also logging when and how much water did the system dispense to each plant, so we can correlate that data as well. Another nice thing is that I can easily integrate Grafana dashboard into other systems, like for example this Home Assistant dashboard that I can use to keep an eye on my plants and water plants manually if I want to. Although I'm almost never using the manual watering feature, but it's there if I ever need it. Also, I have noticed one very exciting thing, and that's that most of my plants have grown 2 to 3 times their original size and also have developed beautiful, vivid colors since the system started watering them. For me, this is more than enough, since honestly, I think that most of my houseplants would probably be okay with just getting any reasonable amount of water a couple of times a week. As I mentioned in the part 2 of this video series, our central unit also has the ability to receive commands. And the main command we are going to use is to tell it which plant to water and with how much water. To be more precise, we can send an HTTP request to the central unit, and as a GET parameter, we specify which solenoid valve to open and how much water to dispense. This allows us to do so many cool things, like water the plant every time with exactly the same amount of water. But we would have to do this manually, which is very boring, at least for me. So we are going to automate this part, and again, we are going to use N8N, the same system we used in the previous step. Now, I encourage you here to avoid overcomplicating your automation, so maybe just stop for a second and think what your plants actually need. Sure, we could easily go really fancy and check soil moisture every hour. If it's too low, dispense tiny amount of water, wait a couple of minutes, check soil moisture again, and basically repeat this process over and over until either soil moisture has reached the target level or we have dispensed maximum allowed amount of water for that day. This is relatively easy to do with N8N or Node-RED or any other automation software, and there are many examples on how to do this, but it's probably a complete overkill for most applications, including mine. So I'm not going to go that extreme, but it's nice to have an option if I ever want to. For my plants, I found that they grow really well when I dispense 50 to 100 milliliters of water 2 to 3 times a day. So I chose a very simple workflow where every morning around sunrise, the system will dispense 50 to 100 milliliters of water depending on the plant, and then do the same thing again just before nightfall. I also added a couple of additional features in the workflow, like logging into database how much water was dispensed and for which plant. Also, I added a branch for sending an alert just in case this workflow ever fails. I found that this watering pattern works really well for my plants, but since we have created a really powerful system here, I encourage you to experiment and adjust the automation to fit your use case. As I mentioned, I have been using this system for over a year now, and I'm really happy with how it works, and I think my plants are feeling the same way. The goal of this video series was to have fun and design a useful system for myself, and hopefully in the process, someone else found this useful as well. Now, I think that we have built a respectable watering system, but keep in mind that obviously this system was designed by me, for me, and what I mean by that is that a lot of design decisions were influenced by things like parts I already have, automation I already have running, or designing and using the watering system in a way that works for me and my plants. With that said, this is a completely open source project, so feel free to use it as is, or even better, modify it to fit your needs and share it with the maker community. Now, as I mentioned, there are a couple of things I would change in the future, like maybe to have a single connector on the sensor board and have it on the top side. Right now, I'm daisy chaining the sensors, which works great, but it limits how close and how deep you can put the sensor in the planter before cables start getting in the way. Also, single cable should be easier to cable manage. For my use case, I could have gone without ambient light sensor and temperature sensor since I have so many of them nearby where my plants are. But it's a nice additional data point and I thought someone else might find it useful or it can come in handy if you're using these sensors outside, like on a balcony or your DIY greenhouse or a garden. One thing that I would add to the central unit is a sensor to detect when water tank is empty. My current water tank can hold more than enough water for the entire week, and it's also always visible, so it's easy to see when you need to top it up. But some people might find this feature a nice to have, and also it would be kind of neat to get a notification to tell you that you need to add more water to the tank. Although even with this system, you could do this programmatically by measuring how much water you have dispensed so far. I have to say that I'm somewhat surprised with how well these low-cost prototyping PCBs are still holding up, even after being in fairly wet soil for over a year now. I did notice that on some boards, Solar Mask has developed these tiny bubbles from exposure to moisture, but the most important thing is that the sensors are still working and reading the same values as they did initially, which is exactly what we want. And that's all for today's video. Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below, or what would you like to see next? If you like this video, hit that like button and maybe consider subscribing to my channel to see more cool videos like this one. My name is Sasha, thank you all for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!